This is All In, a Nicky Lyons FBI suspense thriller, Book 8, written by Blake Pierce, narrated by Elizabeth Ruelas. Prologue. A chill ran through Moira's dress, making her skin prick from the cold. She stood at the front of the movie theater as the last of the lineup trickled in behind her, leaving her out on the street alone. The full moon hung behind the clouds above her. She took a breath and checked her phone. No texts yet. As her cell phone screen went dark, she caught her reflection. She dressed up nice, put on a lot of makeup, and took out her gold earrings, only to be stood up. At least, this was how it felt. There was still a chance Harry could show up for their first date. They'd been chatting online for a while now, and he had seemed so eager to meet her. Moira doubted he would just not show up when he said he was leaving his house 30 minutes ago. Maybe something happened, she thought with worry. Maybe he got in a car accident, or maybe he just changed his mind about you. She sighed, hoping he wasn't going to be another dud. Moira's heart sank as she began to lose hope. She had been on so many bad dates that she was beginning to think that she would never find true love. It was late, after midnight, and the street was dead. There had been a flurry of activity outside, but they'd all gone into the movie over 15 minutes ago, leaving Moira alone. She kicked a small pebble on the sidewalk, sending it skidding across the pavement. Moira stared at her phone, as if willing a message from Harry to pop up. But the screen remained blank, mocking her with its lifelessness. She cursed under her breath and pulled her coat tighter around herself, trying to fend off the cold. She was about to go back inside the theater to watch the movie alone when she heard a car pull up in front of her. She lifted her eyes to see a white pickup truck with the window rolled down. A man leaned forward, his face obscured by shadow, so she could barely make out his features. Moira glanced around the dark street. They were the only ones left on it.
"Excuse me, miss, do you know where Terry Street is?" the man asked.
Moira frowned. Terry Street? She'd never heard of it. Unnerved by this man's presence, she waved him off.
"Sorry, no,"
she said, then turned away. Thankfully, he took the hint and began to drive off slowly. Just as the truck was about to turn the corner, Moira heard a loud screech of tires against concrete. She spun around and saw the truck veer off its path and head straight for her. Moira's heart pounded in her chest as she stumbled backward, her thoughts racing wildly as she tried to process what was happening. The sound of the screeching tires filled her ears, drowning out her own panicked breaths as she watched the truck hurtling towards her. She had to move, had to get out of the way, but her legs felt like jelly, refusing to obey her frantic commands. For a moment, she was frozen in terror, the world around her slowing down to a crawl as she braced herself for impact. In a split second before the truck hit her, Moira saw the driver's face. It was twisted in a grotesque sneer, his eyes glinting with manic glee. She felt a surge of fear and anger as she realized that this was no accident. This man was trying to kill her. The impact came, and Moira was thrown into the air. She felt a sharp pain as her body hit the pavement with a crack. Her head felt light as she tried to stand, adrenaline coursing through her, forcing her to push past the pain. She couldn't die here, not like this. She stumbled to her feet and tried to limp toward the movie theater, but she heard the door of the truck open and slam behind her. Moira turned back to see the man running right at her. Her heart raced even faster as she tried to run, but her injured leg couldn't keep up, tripping her and sending her tumbling to the ground. The man was getting closer, his footsteps growing louder in her ears. Moira frantically crawled away, but the man grabbed her by the hair
and pulled her up to her feet.
"Let go of me!"
Moira screamed, struggling against him. But he was too strong for her, his grip like iron around her wrist.
"What do you want from me?"
she shouted, trying to.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.